Let's go on now. We've been talking about, I've been sharing with you, I've been showing you what the Lord showed us through a revelation, a wonderful revelation of the Lamb of God and the glory of this book. But now we are entering into the tribulation. Finally, in chapter 8, we are entering the tribulation in the times. And I showed you how the sixth seal, the seven trumpets, and the seven bowls of wrath all cover the same thing. And that it's in the tribulation, and that the bowls of wrath and the trumpets are the same thing. The trumpets are messages to God's people to get prepared, to give them instructions, to bring them together, to get them ready to march for war. And the bowls of wrath are to the unsaved, those that turn to the Antichrist, that turn to the kingdom of the beast, and the wrath of God is on them. It's the outcome of those who reject Christ. And by the end of the tribulation, the results of these things that you see in the trumpets. And we talked about how the seals cover the entire church age, when men can and will be saved. If you didn't see this, go back and see the previous messages. And please subscribe. I want to share these things so you can share them. I want nothing from you, but I want you to subscribe to hear these messages and to pass these messages on, that you will be the voice of one crying in the wilderness. And we also talked about the trumpets and the bowls of wrath are the same thing. We talked about the first two trumpets and the first two bowls of wrath are covering an asteroid hitting the earth. It's so clear there's nothing else it could be. And now we're going on in Revelation chapter 8, verse 10, the third trumpet. And what do we have here, saints? And the third angel sounded. And remember, angels are bringing you, the saints, a message from God. That's why these are to the saints, and the bowls of wrath are the same thing, but they're to the unsaved by the end of the tribulation and the outcome of them rejecting Christ. And the third angel sounded, and a great star fell from heaven, burning like a torch, and it fell on a third of the rivers and on the springs of water. This is just another view, another message, another witness to that one asteroid hitting. A great star fell from heaven, burning like a torch. You couldn't have a clearer message again, a clearer picture of an asteroid coming down. They burn like a torch as they fall to earth. And this is another message, another aspect. We saw it burn in the trees and the grass. We saw it hitting in the ocean and killing one third of the beast, the life in that ocean. And then we saw in the bowls of wrath, by the end of the tribulation, that whole ocean was dead. And here again, this is a message from an angel regarding to fresh water. And it's in that country where that asteroid hits. And it says, and it fell on a third of the rivers and on the springs of water. This asteroid will kick up debris, sulfur, acid rain. There'll be nuclear power plants that will destroy chemical plants. All the debris and garbage and chemicals from a city will be kicked up into the air and fall down for a great distance. And as they fall in the water, in the springs, in the streams, and the lakes, they will become one third of the rivers and streams will immediately become poisoned by it. And now let's go to the bowl of the wrath. How do the bowls of wrath, how does the third one correspond to this? Listen, saints, in Revelation chapter 16, verse 4, and the third angel poured out his bowl into the rivers and the springs of water, and they became blood. We talked about that becoming blood in the ocean. It said it was death. It was the blood of a dead man. There's nothing alive there. There's nothing to gain from it. There's no food, no water. Here it's talking about the springs and the fresh water in the rivers. And by the end of the tribulation, they become blood. They become poisoned, the whole thing. It's a message to those that reject God, reject his kingdom, reject his salvation, reject his son. What will be the outcome of it? The rivers, from the time the asteroid hits, there's fresh water in that area. One third of it will be destroyed. And throughout the tribulation, it will spread through the atmosphere further and further, and it will affect the water further and further until the water becomes worthless. And now let's go to the fourth angel. In verse 12, Revelation chapter 8, verse 12, and the fourth angel sounded, and a third of the sun, and a third of the moon, and a third of the stars were smitten, so that a third of them might be darkened, and the day might not shine for a third of it, and the night in the same way. See, everything's a third. It's a third, a third, a third. Because as that asteroid hits, it's going to affect one third of that area. And here it's talking about the sun and the moon and the stars, and they're not giving their light. How could they? The asteroid is going to kick up a giant plume. That volcano that just erupted in the Pacific not far long ago put up that big plume cloud of dust and debris. This is going to be vastly bigger, and it's going to block out a third of the sun and a third of the moon at that time. And it also was shown in the sixth seal. Because in the sixth seal, we saw in verse 12, and the sun became black as sackcloth, made of hair, and the whole moon became like blood. The sixth seal and the trumpets and the bowls of wrath are all describing one event. It's not 14, 15, 20, 30, 40 wild, terrible disasters continuously coming upon the earth. These things are describing one thing that will set up the tribulation, bring down that government that rules the earth and its commerce is, the world is so dependent upon. And that will make way for the kingdom of the beast to quickly rise up and for to even demand that people use his number to buy, sell, and trade, to eat. That could only happen if there's still enough going on the earth that he can control people like that. And people are buying, selling, eating. And let's go to Revelation chapter 16 again. And the fourth bowl in verse 8. And what does it say? And the fourth angel poured out his bowl upon the sun and was given it to scorch men with the heat. And men were scorched with fierce heat, and they blasphemed the name of God who has the power over these plagues. And they did not repent. At the end, going to the very end of the tribulation, they're not repenting. They're cursing God for what's happened. The saints have been preaching to them, telling them to get ready, prepare. But they're cursing God. And they don't give him glory. So we see, once again, in the third and the fourth trumpet, the third trumpet's affecting the fresh water, one third of it at the beginning of the tribulation. The third bowl of wrath, it's affecting the whole water supply, especially in that area, and it will spread around the world as time goes on throughout the tribulation. The fourth trumpet, it's describing the cloud that's kicked up from the asteroid as it hits the earth, and it's blocking out the sun and the moon and making them dark. And in the fourth bowl, it's causing men to be burned by the chemicals and the sun and the depleted ozone. That by the end of the tribulation, they're cursing God. They're not turning to God. The trumpets are messages to God's people. Those that were not waiting, were not watching, and they go into the tribulation, they will have the latter-day rain poured out upon them, and they will become the biggest, most powerful, anointed witnesses for God in the history of the church. It'll be the latter day rain. But those that reject that message, reject God's grace, follow the kingdom of the beast and the Antichrist, they will be doomed and they will fall into these curses. The bowls of wrath are the wrath of God upon those who reject him. This is the coming of the Lord. This is his message. We are to get ready. We are to repent and prepare the way of the Lord. And I want to say something to you older people here. Like me, I'm almost 70 years old. And I believe the Lord's coming in my lifetime. It sure seems with what he's showing us and the power and the glory he's sharing with us, it seems like it's in my lifetime. But I, like you, we're in the 70s and the 80s, and we were told that it was the latter-day rain and the glory of God, and it was all coming. And since then, it's went on with almost nothing. But this is the day This is the day, you folks that are like me. Get ready. You can come to the field late and you can work and get the same reward, the same pay as those that have been working longer. Get ready, saints, especially you older saints, you young saints. Prepare the way of the Lord. Repent, repair the way of the Lord, because he is coming.